Hi, this is Rajkumar. Today we are going to discuss about this topic, chemistry of sandwich complexes or metallocene. Let us come to the first section about structure and bonding in metallocene. Let us first consider the molecular orbital diagram of metallocene. If we look at this diagram carefully, we can see that all the frontal molecular orbitals are metal centered. The ligand centered bonding molecular orbitals are very low in energy, and there are total 9 bonding and non-bonding orbitals that can accommodate total 18 electrons. So let us compare the structural parameters for these sandwich complexes. So if we see carefully, the metal carbon bond distance and the distance between the cyclopentadiene rings, they vary significantly across all these complexes. But if we look at the carbon-carbon bond distance, it remains practically constant. Now, what are the reasons for this? If we look at carefully, this iron and this cobalt complex are 80 electron species. So, all the bonding and non-bonding orbitals are occupied and the antibonding orbitals are vacant. As a result, they are having the highest bond order. So the metal carbon bond is the shortest, resulting the shortest distance between the CP rings. Now, if we come to this cobaltocene and nickelocene, they are 19 and 20 electron species. These extra electron goes to the antibonding orbitals. That reduces the metal carbon bond order. So the metal carbon bond becomes longer. Now in this chromium and vanadium complex, exactly opposite thing happens. They have less number of electrons. So some of the bonding and non-bonding levels are now vacant. As a result, here is also the bond order is less. Now let us come to the carbon-carbon bond distance. As the ligand-centered molecular orbitals are very low in energy, just addition or removal of few electrons do not change the carbon-carbon bond order significantly. Let us see the properties of different metallocene. So, among all these complexes, ferrocene and leucinocene, they are highly stable. Whereas these vanadium, chromium, manganese, cobalt, nickel complexes are very unstable. They are highly moisture sensitive or air sensitive. Now, why is it so? As ferrocene and leucinocene are 80 electron species, they are the most stable ones. Now in ferrocene, due to low ionic radii of iron, the CP rings are very close. So the aromatic rings adopt staggered conformation to avoid the steric interactions. In leucinocene, now the rings are a bit far apart. So the aromatic rings adopt eclipse configuration to maximize the electron dislocalization across these rings. Now cobaltocene and nickelocene are 90 and 20 electron species. So they contain electrons in high energy antibonding orbitals. Now these electrons can be easily removed, that can cause oxidation. So these complexes are very prone to aerial oxidation. Whereas in manganese, chromium, vanadium complexes, they have vacant low-lying orbital. So they are very prone to nucleophilic attack, for example water. As a result, they are very moisture sensitive. Now we come to the next section. Let us concentrate more on the most popular sandwich complex, that is ferrocene. Let us come to the historical background of this complex. It was discovered accidentally by Kelly and Poisson. They wanted to synthesize phalbalin, which is an organic semiconductor, by oxidizing cyclopentadienyl gignard reagent by this reaction. So they expected a colorless compound to form, but instead they obtained an orange colored compound which is having a very high air as well as thermal stability. So by this color they have guessed that that compound has to contain a metal. So they proposed the structure as combination of these two reagent structures. This is ionic form and metal carbon single bonded complex. almost at the same time, Miller, Tebow and Tremaine synthesize the same compound by reducing cyclopentadiene with iron. But Wilkinson, Woodward and Fisher raised the doubt about the structure suggested by Kelly and Pawson. Wilkinson believed that a metal complex with simple metal carbon bond cannot be so stable. After synthesizing the cobalt and ruthenium complexes, he proposed the sandwich complex for the first time, which was later validated. Due to aromaticity of ferrocene, Woodward introduced the name ferrocene, analogous to the benzene. Later, all other complexes in the same series was termed as metallocene. Later, Island and Pepinski confirmed the structure by X-ray as well as NMR. So, by X-ray crystallography, they have shown that all the metal carbon bonds are equivalent, and NMR suggested that all the carbons are exactly same. Now, let us come to some properties of ferrocene. It is having a similar resonance energy like benzene. But unlike benzene, it's a three-dimensional aromatic compound. Here, two cyclopentadienyl ligands, they communicate through iron and they undergo the three-dimensional electronic delocalization. Due to presence of negative charge in the CP rings, they are much more electron-rich compared to benzene. So, they are more reactive towards electrophilic attack than benzene. But due to their redox activity, the reagents with oxidizing ability cannot be used. For example, nitric acid, fuming sulfuric acid. Let's come to the next section about the reactions of ferrocene and its derivative. Let us come to the one of the most popular electrophilic substitution reaction, that is Friedel-Crafts reaction. Now, due to electron rich nature, the alkylation reaction cannot be controlled and it always gives multiple number of substitution reactions, leading to mixture of products. Because upon alkylation, the ring becomes much more susceptible to electrophilic attack. The reaction can only be controlled if the substituents are sterically bulky enough. Now, we move towards the other Friedel-Crafts reaction, acylation. With weak acylating reagents, they give monoacylation. Whereas, strong acylating reagents leads to diacylation. So, if we come, this weakly reactive reagent gives a monoacylation, whereas this strong acylating reagent gives a diacylation. And it's important to note that the same reagents gives only monoacylation in case of benzene. These are few other electrophilic substitution reactions that gives the different type of products. Among these, this particular product is very important, which is known as Ugi's amine. Lithiation reactions. With only butyl lithium, it gives a monolithiated product, whereas in presence of TMEDA only, it gives dilithiation. Now, why is so? Because among monolithiation, this particular ring becomes much more electron rich. Now, due to three-dimensional aromaticity, this charge is now transferred somewhat to this ring also. So, this ring becomes much more negatively charged compared to this original neutral analog. So, the second lithiation becomes difficult. But now, TMEDA enhances the basicity of butyl lithium that enables the second lithiation. So, these are few reactions of the monolithiated ferrocene and these are few reactions of the dilithiated ferrocene, giving rise to different fused rings as well as some chelating ligands. Let us discuss few Ugi amine derivatives. Now, this particular compound can be synthesized from Ugi amine by simply reaction with methyl iodide. Now, this Ugi amine can lead to several various reactions like this. Now, we come to the next section, chirality of ferrocene derivatives. Now, there are three types of chirality exist in phaeocytes: central chirality, axial chirality, and planar chirality. Central chirality, it is nothing but the chirality due to presence of a chiral carbon substituent in the CP ligand. Like this, here this carbon is a chiral center. Now, axial chirality, this type of chirality happens due to 1-1' disubstitution. Such type of similar chiralities are also observed in biphenyl and bidiphenyl systems also. Now, this chirality is due to the staggered conformation of phaeocene and restricted rotation along the metal ligand bond due to the steric effect of the substituents. Now, upon heating, this metal carbon bond becomes elongated and this substituent moves far apart. Then it can undergo free rotation and that causes sensibilization. So now if we visualize this complex in the perpendicular plane, we can easily see this complex and its mirror image is non-superimposable. Now let us move to planar chirality. Such type of chirality is unique for metallocene, paracyclophane and half sandwich complexes. This type of chirality occurs in metallocenes having two different substituents in the same ring and they never racemizes. We can clearly see this particular complex, which contains a phosphine and a amine substituent, cannot be superimposed with this mirror image. Let us come to the nomenclature of such molecules. These molecules are first viewed by keeping the substituent CP ring on the top. Then, priority order of these substituents are assigned as per CIP sequence rule. Then, if the shortest path from the highest priority substituent to the next one is clockwise, then the configuration will be RP. If the same path is anti-clockwise, then it will be SP. Let us see the examples. First come to here. This phosphine is first priority and this amine is second priority. And the shortest path is anti-clockwise. So it's a SP configuration. Now in this case, the shortest path is clockwise. So it's a RP configuration. Finally, thank you very much for your kind attention.